Good morning, folks. I'm going to continue on with the Zinsser primer testing today. And what I've got here is some denatured alcohol. Some of this stuff right here. Yeah. And I'm going to thin down the primer with that and then soak a piece of this carbon felt in it. And then we'll throw that between the electrodes and see what we get on that. So there's 100 milliliters, something like that in there, 50 milliliters, somewhere between in there. I've already shaken this up a little bit, and I'm just going to dip a little bit out of here with a spoon. And put it in the alcohol, stir it up. Cover this stuff up, and it dries fast. Alright. Try to get it off the spoon. This stuff is a really good primer. If you need to cover up crayon marks, your kids will work on the walls, or smoke damage, whatever. Most of it out of the spoon. And I'll take our piece of carbon felt, throw it in there, hold it under water. Press the bubbles out of it. Okay. Get it out of there. Get it all over my fingers. Okay. Just throw that on there. It should work as a separator, which we discovered in a previous video. Alright. Now we'll take a graphite and copper, throw it on there. And let's see what we got. Alright. 88, slowly climbing, oh, starting to pick up speed, so it looks like it's going to do the same thing, climb up to around one fold or so. In that last video, I watched it for the first time after I'd already published it, and I kept saying titanium dioxide on the paper, and it was the Benz primer I put on there, which of course had the titanium dioxide, which is what I meant. Alright, so it's a little, it's climbing slower. It'll probably make it to one volt, but it'll, I don't want to take forever to let it get there. Stop at 0.95 this time, and then short it out and see how it does. There's 0.95, and 100 milliamps. All right. All right. It's slow. low, but it's thick. So we got to, what, 0.8 or 0.8? No, point B, 0.8. Alright, let's go back and let it self-charge again. See if we notice any differences on that. You can see that the closer you get these plates together, the faster charge you got on it, or self-charge I should say. As you can see, I'm obviously not adding any external power to this. Alright, so we're almost back to 0.95. Had a bad connection. It was actually a little higher than that. All right, let's see what we got on. Well, it should be a little higher, I'm thinking. Well, this is bad. It's about the same. Hard to tell with that thick felt on there. Push it down real hard and see. Let me take this piece of pad here. See if we can get some higher amps out of this. Yeah, that's going to make a mess. Maybe I better not do that. So anyway, I just wanted to see how this worked. I think the next thing I'm going to do is let this dry, and then soak it in some a little bit of PVA and water, a dilute solution of that, and then let that dry, and then dip it in some borax water, and link all that stuff together, and then we'll come back and try this again. Works on there. That's the separator of the piece of carbon. And well, you can see I've got some titanium, or I should say, primer on that. Of course, there's some on that. But it works fine just like that. That titanium dioxide being a semiconductor could be an insulator or a conductor. So that's obviously the explanation of how that can work like that without having any paper separator between the stuff. Alright, thanks for watching. See you next time. Back again. Rather than waste that little bit of alcohol and primer that I mixed together, I threw it in with a little bit of white glue and water that I mixed up before, and so we're like 20% white glue and 80% water, and it makes a nice, it actually got a little thicker as soon as I mixed it together. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to put some on this wax paper here, spread it around and let it dry, make a little thin film out of it. And we'll test that in a future video. Let's see if I can. Let's pour this on here. Place is starting to smell like a brewery in here. All this alcohol evaporating. Alright, I'm just going to let that sit just like that and dry here. I'm going to go outside and start assembling my Ethernet cable inside the PVC pipe. That ran over to the shop, so I'll be back later. Thanks.